In this video, I explain 2x2 direction control valve. So in this image, you see the one directional control valve is a spool type and second one is the rotary spool type. Means both are the spool type. One is the sliding spool and second one is the rotary spool types. So I explain these both the types in this video with the symbol. So first we understand the 2x2 sliding spool type. Sliding spool means the spool is slide. Okay, and in a rotary spool, the spool is rotated. So that is the basic difference between them. Now what this 2x2 is indicate? Okay, so first 2 is indicate the 2 part is used. And the second 2 is indicate that is a 2 position is the possible. Okay, means in a one position, the fluid is supply from one pot to another pot. And second position is the stop position. Both the valves are closed. So this valve has a 2 part and the 2 position of the spools. Right? I already explained the first 2 is indicate that is a 2 parts. And the second 2 is indicate that is a 2 position. Suppose the next type is the 3x2. Then the first is 3 letter. 3 means there is a 3 part is used. And the 2 position is there. That means it is a 3x2. The 2 part are inlet port A and outlet port B. Means that is a port name is given. One port is known as the inlet port A. And the second port is known as the outlet port B. So here you see this image of the 2x2 sliding spool types. Okay, so this part is called as the spool. Okay, and this is called as the push button. And here you see this is the port A and this is the port B. Okay, so this is the inlet port A. Here we mention inlet port A. Okay, so this A is inlet port and B is the outlet port. Means working fluid is enter from these sides and deliver from these sides. And this is the second position is used. Okay, so in the first position you see this is a closed valve. Means the fluid enter from the port A is not supplied to the port B. Means it is the normally closed type valves. And when we press this spool by this push button, at that time we achieve the second position. And here you see that the spool is moved. Okay, here the spool position and spring position is different. When we push this button of the spool, we achieve the second position. In the second position, you see the port A is open. So what amount of the oil or A? Compressed air is coming. Suppose it is a hydraulic system, then oil is come. Suppose it is pneumatic systems, then the compressed air or a gas is coming. So it is entered in port A and from the A, it is supplied to the B port. And from the B port, it is supplied to the further hydraulics or a pneumatic systems. And here you see this is the symbol of the 2x2 directional control valves. Here you see that is a 2 square is drawn. Okay, means for the first position, 1 square is drawn. And for the second position, the second square is drawn. Suppose it is a 3 position, means second digit is 3. Then we need to draw the 3 square. Okay. But here the 2 position is there. That means we draw the 2 square. And here you see this oil is coming from the A port. And arrow is in upper direction. Means it is supplied to the B ports. Okay. And this type, T type of the symbol is indicate the both the port is closed. Okay. Means here in a first position, you see the A and B are closed. Means for this position, means for this diagram, the position correct is this B second position here, okay. And in this case, you see the fluid coming from the A port is supplied to the B port, okay. For that, we draw the one vertical arrow in a upper directions, okay. This is indicate the spring types, okay. So here you see the spring is provided. So this is the symbol of the spring. And here you see this is the symbol of the push button types, okay. So these are the different types of the lever is used to operate the directional control valve that we already studied in a chapter 1, that is the various types of the symbol used in hydraulic and pneumatic systems. The figure show a sliding spool. So here you see this is a sliding spool and this spool is the spring return types. Okay, that's why the complete name is mentioned: sliding spool, spring return type, normally closed, 2x2 DCV. DCV means direction control valve. Okay, why it is mentioned normally closed? Because in a normal condition, normal means when we are not push this button, at that time valve is normally closed. Means the fluid enter in A port is not supplied there to the B port. It is called as the closed position. So when we not press this switch, at that time the fluid is not supplied. That means the valve is closed. That's why it is a normally closed type valve. In a normal position of a spool, the port are closed. Working fluid cannot flow from port A to port B. When the plumb button is pressed, means it is pressed by our hand and the spool is moved to open the passage. So here you see when we press, so here the space of the spool is changed, okay. The spool is moving insides, Okay, and when the spool is moving inside, so here this open the passage of this port A. So here whatever thing is written, the spool is moved to open the passage from port A to port B, and hence the working fluid move from port A to port B. So this is the end of the sliding spool valve. Now we understand the rotary spool types. Now before moving it, I request to like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the OHP as well as other subject of the mechanical engineering. For the OHP, various link is provided in descriptions as well as in a card bin on a top right screen of your mobile or laptop. You see the eye symbols. For other subject, I request to visit the playlist. Now second is the rotary spool type 2x2 direction control valves. The figure show a rotary spool type 2x2 directional control valve. So here you see that is a two diagram is there. Okay, first one is for the normally closed position and second diagram is for the open positions. Okay, so this is the spool. Rotary means they spool are rotated. Okay, by using the some mechanisms. This is the outer body. Okay, or a valve body. So here you see the valve body is the returns. So in a valve body, we are provided two port. That is the inlet port A, and here you see this is the outlet port B. And inside this valve body, we provide the rotary spools. Okay, we need to rotate these spools. So right now you see that the inside the spool one hollow passage is there, and these hollow passage are not matched with the inlet port and outlet port B. Means the working fluid enter in inlet valve A is not supplied to the outlet part B because here the closed space is there. Means the working fluid is not supplied. Means oil or air or gas is not supplied to the outlet port B. In a second position, you see that the spool is rotated. Then what happen? This hole of the spool is matched with the inlet port A and outlet port B. Means what amount of the hydraulic oil or a compressed air or a gas is enter in a inlet port A is enter in this spool, and from the spool it is come in a outlet port B, and from the outlet port B it is supplied whenever it is to the requires. So in a first position of the spool, the port are closed. Working fluid cannot flow from port A to port B. So in first position means in a first diagram you see that the spools are closed, means the port are closed. Okay, port are closed by using these spools, and working fluid is not supplied from the port A to port B. When the spool is rotated through the 90 degree, so we need to rotate this spool 90 degree because you here you see that the hole of the spool has the 90 degree to this outlet port A and the outlet port B and inlet port A. Okay, so when we rotate it 90 degree, okay, in any either direction, either clockwise or anti-clockwise, then this hole of the spool is matched with this inlet port A and outlet port B. So when the spool is rotated through 90 degree, it opened the passage from the port A to port B, and hence the working fluid flow from port A to port B. Means what amount of the oils or air or gas is enter in port A is supplied to spool, and from the spool it is supplied to B, and from this B port it is supplied to the actuators or some other parts of the hydraulics or a pneumatic systems. So thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to the OHP and mechanical engineerings, and don't forget to share with your friends.